This is the Humic Mark 610D, and it's the best projector ever made. In this video I want to show how this projector works and why it is different from most other projectors you know. And let's dive into the mechanics of this projector, and to explain it better to you I'm going to get some parts I took out of a donor projector. I have here from a donor projector, which was a Bolix 18-3 Duo, the mechanical setup, so you can see what's going on inside. First of all, notice the shutter has a weird shape compared to the classic projectors. The blades are at an angle, and it's because of this. The main axle is not in line with the film gate, and because you want the edges of the shutter to black out the image horizontally, the angles on the shutter blade are adapted accordingly. You can see them blacking out here horizontally. When I go further, you see him opening up again horizontally. Then there is another feature I find interesting. Normally, when you put your projector in reverse, the motor will spin in the other direction. But because Humic uses a special kind of motor, this is not possible. The motor can only spin in one direction and lacks power. So this is their solution, so you are able to reverse the projection. On the back side of the shutter you see two different paths that direct the claw movement. The upper is forward and the lower is reverse. When you change the direction of the film, the claw shifts from one path to the other. Also notice that these gears change. This is forward and this is reverse by replacing one gear for two gears. The lack of power can also be a problem, as the motor does not have enough kick to get the claw over the cam lobes from a standstill. Therefore, on the motor is a spring-loaded pulley, so the motor has a little time to get up to speed so it can kick the mechanics into motion. Sometimes, when the belt gets old, the projector just hums when forward motion is selected and will not start playing. The main problem is that the old belt is not flexible enough anymore to get around the small motor pulley, and if the claw is against the cam lobe, this means too much friction to overcome. The quick remedy is quickly shifting it in reverse and then forward again to build up speed before it reaches the cam lobe again. The long-term solution is to replace the belt. The projector also features a plug on the rear that makes it possible to start a cassette recorder via the remote port. The cable that's needed is some kind of unicorn, as in 21 years of collecting I have never seen this cable. This apparently was not a popular feature. This projector is sprocketless. Here you can see the spring-loaded elements that replace the function of the sprockets. And because this is a dual gauge projector, you can simply select the film type you want to play by a selector, and the only changes happen in the gate. Now let's go into the slow motion system. Classic built projectors do slow motion by just decreasing the speeds they play the film with. This is also not possible with this type of motor, so a mechanical solution was needed. The answer is this drum, and the magic word is camshaft. Let's open up a Mark 501 first, because it has a very basic slow motion system and the principles of this are visible and are the same in the 610. When the projector runs, you can see that this cam is also turning. This arm could reach it, but it's not engaged. The movement of the claw is now 18 frames per second and follows the cam of the shutter. Now, when the slow motion is engaged, this lever falls upon the cam and prevents the claw from going forward. The up and down movement is still there, but the claw cannot grab into the film and therefore the film is not being transported. The frame rate is now 9 frames per second because this cam lobe lifts the claw every other image. And because the motor still spins at 18 fps, there will never be flicker visible. So, now back to the 610D with its 6 slow motion settings. Imagine that cam and its principal. Then stack any cam you want on top of it and place it inside the drum. The cam always spins when the motor turns, but it cannot engage the claw lifter because they can't reach it. Now the drum it spins inside of has the pressure pieces it needs to reach the claw lifter. This drum can also rotate. And at the various speed settings, the corresponding pressure piece is placed between the right cam lobe and the claw lifter. This way you can have different film speeds and never change the projector's running speed. Standstill is also possible because you now lift the claw all the time. And what about burning the film now, because the film speed is lower but your lamp still burns at the same intensity? Well, there are two filters that shift between the lamp and the film to prevent the film from overheating and burning. Every Humic projector has this little feature. This is the voltage selector, so you can change voltage to wherever you are in the world. This one is made for the European market only because it has 250, 240, 230 and 220. I set them always at 240 volts. One that has a transformer that's meant for America will have a 110 volt setting too. There's also a clever way to set your net frequency on these projectors. They have two pulleys, a big one and a small one. The bigger is for 50 Hz regions and the smaller one is for 60 Hz regions. So in this this way you make only needed to use one type of motor for the entire world. Okay, so this is how this ingenious projector works. Some notes. The UMAC R2000, the Bolex 102 MTC and the Revue Lux 8000 have also the exact same projector mechanics inside, but the mechanism is turned upside down and runs backwards as opposed to the 600. This means these projectors also have the slow motion features and they work in the same way. So if you are getting interested in film, these projectors are ideal to start with. They last a lifetime and seldom go wrong. And when they go wrong, it usually is a lack of surface or bad storage. My own personal collection even started with a UMIC Mark 607D. So for me, this type of projector has made a big impression on my life. Also, there are many still out there, so you can pick them up for good prices. So I think that's enough babble for today, and I'm going to watch a movie now. See you later.